Perception is an interesting take on the adventure and exploration game genres. In it, you play a blind woman with some special gifts. She has a connection to the spirit world and the ability to make her way through her surroundings via echolocation. This blind protagonist has been tried in games before. Has developer Deep End pulled off the compelling title they hope to? I'm Josh with TrueGaming Network with my first impression of Perception. From the outset, Perception pulls off some interesting and immersive visuals. The echolocation mechanic allows you to tap and fill out your surroundings around you. This type of mechanic has been used in the past, but this utilization, paired with the first-person perspective, allowed the designers to play a lot of atmospheric tricks on the player. Objects are moved by unknown forces, doors open and slam closed, footsteps can be heard down hallways, and howling wind all allow for jump scares and guided exploration. I really like the Pathfinder mechanics. Feeling my way through this apparently abandoned mansion made traversal a rewarding task. This also sets up plenty of tricks, since you never fully have an idea of a full visual representation of the environment. Rooms can change and rearrange at will. All this adds to the atmosphere of the game, and the choice of a blind protagonist really is rewarded with these mechanics. Normally, games in the walking simulator genre are knocked due to the mostly passive nature of the experience. This game takes some steps to avoid it. There are malevolent forces at work in the house you're exploring. Making too much noise draws the attention of some spectral hunters, and the only recourse you have is to seek cover. This set up some tense situations in my first hour of playthrough, where the main mechanic for pathfinding also increases the risk of attack. I liked this balance. I think it adds some additional urgency to the gameplay. You'll always need to balance your ability to see your surroundings as well as hiding from the enemy. Looking at the achievement list for this game revealed that most of the achievements are linked to collectibles, as is the norm for this style of gameplay. I was actually able to grab a few with no guide in my first hour of play. There are some story-related achievements, as well as the normal complete the game without doing this or that. Overall, the list looks about par for this style of game. I really enjoyed my first hour with Perception. It set out to do something a bit different with that walking simulator genre, and for the most part it succeeded. The blind protagonist is an interesting hook, the writing and voice acting is good, and the colorful visuals are refreshing after so many dark, brown and gray dungeons. Overall, I'd recommend this game as an interesting diversion to anyone who likes story-driven games, as well as people looking for some easy achievements. I've been Josh with the TrueGaming Network. Thanks for watching. Remember to like and subscribe for more videos like this, and check us out on trueachievements.com. And remember, be excellent to each other.